President Trump gives brutal nickname to LaVar Ball, wrecks his world with two words. LaVar Ball is a tool. That was proven when he tried to use his kid's popularity, what little he had, to sell $500 sneakers that aren't worth half that. Too bad for him, he just picked a fight with the wrong guy, and after his public temper tantrum, he just got wrecked when President Donald Trump dropped two brutal words on the pathetic ingrate. There is an ongoing feud between President Trump and the father of a UCLA basketball player who was recently arrested in China for stealing. Of course, the president did what he had to do in order to bring the kids home, but that apparently wasn't good enough for one smug punk. As it turns out, LaVar Ball refused to thank Trump for freeing his son, who was being threatened with up to 5-10 years in a Chinese prison for what he had done. Shockingly, even CNN's Chris Cuomo was forced to defend the president while interviewing Ball, saying that he ultimately owes Trump a thank you. With even leftists saying that the guy is dead wrong, Ball is still intent on making a scene, likely because the attention equates to profits for his lackluster company. Of course, I doubt that he'll acknowledge that the only reason he's making money is because of Trump, but that's a topic for another day. During the interview, Ball threw odd remarks at Cuomo, saying that he would have thanked Trump if he visited his boy in jail, which only made him look worse. I mean, does he really think that the leader of the free world is going to take time out of his day to visit his criminal son in prison? You'd have to be a moron to think that, and Ball is living proof. And now, the focus has been on Ball and his reluctance to thank the man who saved his son. Instead, he offered his praise to Chinese President Xi Jinping for freeing the three players. If I was going to thank somebody, I would probably thank President Xi, Ball said at the time. Too bad for him, Trump was right there to set him straight. While referring to Ball as a poor man's version of Don King, but without the hair, Trump dropped the hammer. It wasn't the White House, it wasn't the State Department, it wasn't Father LaVar's so-called people on the ground in China that got his son out of a long-term prison sentence, it was me, President Trump wrote on Twitter. However, Trump's scathing rebuttal wasn't done there as he was about to drop just two brutal words that would wreck the entitled punk once and for all. Releasing a second tweet, Trump ended it by calling Ball an ungrateful fool, and he hit the nail on the head. At the end of the day, that's exactly what Ball is. Not only is he a moron for not thanking the man who got his son out of prison, but he's showing his true colors. A few months ago, this guy was brought on national television, where he proceeded to humiliate himself while trying to explain the outrageous cost of his new sneakers that were soon to be released. Now, this. Pathetic. Some people would be better off just staying home and being completely quiet, and Ball is one of those guys. Although Ball's son is home, I feel bad for the next guy who does something stupid and gets locked away in a foreign country. Trump might not be so eager to bring them home considering the thanks and hassle he got from this ungrateful fool. My only question is, what will Ball be doing to help get that person out like Trump did for his son? My guess is, absolutely nothing, because this guy is as worthless as it gets.